Hi everyone. Welcome back to MomNMeBeauty. Thank you so much for joining us today. We're going to be doing our top 10 under 10 beauty products. If you're new here, please consider subscribing by hitting that button down below and then the little bell that is right next to it so you're notified every time we upload a new video. We do post twice a week. Emma and I do Mom and Me Day on Mondays, and on Thursdays she either does a teen tank or I do Mom Moment. So without any further ado, let's get into the products.
My first product is probably the cheapest item here, and that is the Pure and Gentle Makeup Remover Wipes. I cannot tell you how many packages of these I have gone through within the past like 2 years. It's ridiculous. I absolutely love these. These are about, I don't know, less than a dollar at Walmart. And whenever we see them, we buy them in bulk. I actually have one more backup left, so I'm going to have to go back to Walmart and get like another 10. Because I absolutely love these.
We have tried other brands and nothing can compare. So just because it's inexpensive or cheap doesn't mean it's bad quality.
Other wipes just break me out or just stain my eyes. So these are perfect. Hence the name, Pure and Gentle.
My first item under $10 is something I've raved about quite a bit, and actually a lot of these products are going to be things that you hear Emma and I talk about a lot in a lot of our videos. But that being said, my first one is the LA Colors Matte Eyeshadow Single in the color Whisper. I got all of my LA Colors singles from Dollar General. However, when I went there last time, I didn't see them on display. You still can get them on several websites, and you may even be able to get a hold of them at your Dollar General. Unfortunately, they just didn't have a display at mine. This particular shade, though, is my perfect skin color, so I can set my eyeshadow primer with this single, and it just blends in seamlessly. On days that I don't really want to wear eye makeup, I can use this to cancel out any pigmentation that's on my lid. It's just the perfect color. It's not too powdery, doesn't dry out, it lasts a long time. I just can't say enough good things about this. Oh, there is one more bonus. It's 50 cents. All of the singles that I purchased were 50 cents at Dollar General. So if you can find them at your local store, pick yourself up some. You will absolutely love them.
My next product is the Rimmel Magnif’Eyes Electraviolet Eyeshadow Palette. When I got this, I was in the search for a nice, solid purple eyeshadow. And since then, I have accumulated way too many purple eyeshadow palettes to the point where it's crazy. So I am very happy right now with all my purple eyeshadows, but these are wonderful. I love the kind of compact packaging. All of my other palettes are quite bulkier. And the pigmentation is great. I love the shades in here, and I love how they added the teal just as a nice pop.
My next product is a eyeliner that, again, I have been talking about for quite some time. It's the NYX Epic Ink Liner, and this is in the color black. It is bar none the best liquid eyeliner that I have ever tried, and I have tried quite a few, both high-end and drugstore. The big thing about this is it's got a brush tip, so it's flexible, it's not stiff, it doesn't drag your lid skin as you're applying it, it doesn't bleed, it dries down matte, it lasts a long, long time. The only thing about this that I don't really care for is if you store it so the tip is facing down, there are little holes near the brush to exchange air. So as the liquid eyeliner is coming out, air goes into the pen to replace, you know, what the liquid was taking up. If you store it like that, so your brush is down, there's going to be liquid eyeliner that comes out through those holes, and then it can be a hot mess applying it. So my recommendation is store it upright so the brush tip is up, or store it level so that the liquid doesn't seep out through those holes. I've not had any problem storing it upright in terms of not getting any liquid to apply to my eyes. I've never once had a problem. It always just applies so smoothly, no problems at all. So yeah, store it upright if you get this liner.
My next favorite is the CoverGirl Total Tease Waterproof Mascara. I used to wear this on my lashes, but since I've been I can't stop touching my L'Oreal Lash Paradise, I tend to notice that this is better for my under eyelashes, right?
Lower lashes?
My lower lashes. and it can really get in there, and it's thin enough to where I can easily reach my lower lash line. Now, I don't apply lower lash line mascara often, like I mentioned before, but when I do, this is a go-to mascara because it will last, it's waterproof, and the brush is just very easy to get onto those lashes, so.
My next product under $10 is, you've heard me say it over and over again, it's the Wet n Wild Photofocus Eyeshadow Primer. Absolutely love this stuff, cannot live without it. So we recently did an empties video. I will link that in the corner up here for you and down in the description bar below if you'd like to check that out. In that empties video, I raved about this. I was really upset that it was empty and that I was going to have to pick up a new one. So Emma and I went and did a little shopping last night. We went to two stores and both stores, I could not find it. Well, then something told me to kind of like go around the corner of the Wet n Wild display and there it was. I thought like I was in a panic. It was discontinued and nobody had it. Fortunately, this particular store did have it. It was around the corner. So this, like I'm gonna have to buy as many as I possibly can get my hands on just so I have backups. However, this did last me a year and a half or more, so maybe getting a backup right now is not such a good idea. This is such a good eyeshadow primer. You do not have to spend a huge amount of money to get a primer by a higher end or prestige brand. This stuff locks in my shadow, does not allow it to crease. I do have oily eyelids. You couldn't tell unless I had no eye makeup on. Like, it's that good. It is such a good eyeshadow primer, and it's so affordable. Oh, absolutely love this stuff.
My last two products are a little bit over $10. I didn't realize that until I checked on Ulta, so it's a little bit over, but not by much. The first one, I know you all know what it's gonna be. It is the Physicians Formula Butter Highlighter. I can't not use this. This is my favorite highlighter that I own. I wear this every day to school, so much so that I have hit pan on this and I have a backup. I absolutely love this. Now, as I said earlier, you can't get this with coupons to get a little bit cheaper, but it's still going to be over $10 if you don't have coupons. So yep, I love this highlighter.
My next product is something that both Emma and I were originally both going to include as our top products, so we agree on this. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Lash Paradise Waterproof Mascara. There is no mascara that has ever beaten it. Absolutely not. It gives incredible length and volume. It lasts a long time. It's waterproof, so it doesn't budge, doesn't smudge, does not flake. I've not even met a high-end brand mascara that can beat this. It is so good. And as per the commercials, one is sold every 7 seconds around the world. So obviously you guys agree with this too. Really good mascara.
Now, my last product is by far the most expensive, but I'm surprised that it's the most expensive. I thought it was gonna be one of the cheapest products. And that is the ULTA Beauty Nude Matte Eye Primer. Now, just like the Physicians Formula, you can all easily get it cheaper, you know, with coupons, but.
It retails for $12.99, but like Emma said, you can get it when it's on sale through Ulta.
When I do wear eyeshadow, which is whenever I have time to put it on, and for school, I struggle to have time. So when I do, I always use this. It really does help to lock down my eyeshadow, especially because I get very oily lids. Especially by the end of the day, I'll notice, like I'll be going to take my makeup off, and I can just like see all the oil collecting on my eyelid. Now I know that sounds pretty gross, but it's true, and with this, you don't even see that most of the time if I applied enough of it and if I let it dry for enough time. So I absolutely love this, but if you want something under $10, I'd wait to get an Ulta coupon for, you know, $5 off or something like that.
My last product under $10 is the CoverGirl TruNaked palettes, specifically the Roses palette. They recently, this year, relaunched their Chocoholic and their Peach Punch palette, and then they also have at least two others. One is called the Goldens, and the last one has got lots of different like bright colors in it. I'm not exactly sure what the name of that one is. However, they've got a whole line of these TruNaked palettes. They retail for $9.99, so it's under $10. The reason why I included this one specifically is just because I absolutely love the shades in here. All pinks and purples, kind of monochromatic, but it definitely works for me and my wheelhouse. We did do a video on the Peach Punch and the Chocoholic palettes, and we will link that video up here in the cards for you and down in the description bar below. The formulation on all of these palettes is extremely good. Even the mattes are not powdery, they're creamy. They're so incredibly pigmented. The shimmers don't have any fallout, and yet they're incredibly intense. This is just two of the shades in this one particularly. I've had this one for, gosh, at least a year, if not longer, and it still feels and works just as good as when I first purchased it. So it's really difficult to find an eyeshadow palette under $10, even at the drugstore, but if you're looking for something like that, check out these CoverGirl TruNaked palettes. You will not be disappointed. They are so good.
So that is it for this video. We both hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to give this video a like if you liked it, and comment down below what your top 10 under 10 are. Be sure to connect with us on Instagram under MomNMeBeauty, and with me under Emma_N_2004 on Instagram and Pinterest. Again, thank you for watching this video, and we will see you next time in our next Mom and Me video.
Bye, everyone.